Hello, and welcome back to the Y Factor, or as the current one would say,
ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my autobiography.
Although a week late, and justifiably so, but we have for the review of Sanju.
अपना लाइफ फुल सांप सीढ़ी का बोर्ड है, कभी अप तो कभी डाउन.
मैं बेवड़ा हूँ, ठरकी हूँ, ड्रग एडिक्ट हूँ, सब हूँ,
लेकिन टेररिस्ट नहीं हूँ. रोल.
A movie which was deserving to be made is debatable, but which should be have been reviewed, especially by yours truly, undoubtedly. Well, I am one of those millions of crazy fans who lived and loved Sanju for what he was in the early 90s. How the earring, the hair, the gym trends. Even for a given matter of fact, that when he came out in 95, I was one of those baboons standing opposite the tree just to get a glimpse of
Baba.
So yeah, there is a fan following which wanted to see this film. And for me particularly, I wouldn't have been able to survive if I had not reviewed this. So here goes. Well, is Sanju a good film? Undoubtedly. Is it one of Hirani's best? I would leave that to opinion because it is debatable. Does he have a bias for Sanju? Undoubtedly. And rightfully so, which producer or director when making a biopic does not have a bias? Steven Spielberg had it during Lincoln. Richard Attenborough had it during Gandhi. Because I feel sometimes this bias makes you come out with what a true story is. One thing Hirani does in the film, like he does always in all his films, that he's made Sanju a Hirani, Rajkumar Hirani movie. So, yes, there is an X amount of sugarcoating involved with everything that Sanju does in life. And the intention is not to glamorize it or to make it sweeter, but just to convey the message. So yes, when he does spend so much of time during his drug trances, the way Hirani shows it is more comic, for the lack of a better word, but mainly more so because he does not want to leave that as a main impact of the story. He sticks to his story about one man, many lives. So yes, it is a Rajkumar Hirani film completely all the way. Will you get a good dose of the Bollywood gossip and the normal fights that Sanju used to have with people? No. Will you have a good dose of the friendships that Sanju had with people during Bollywood days? Yes and no. Because he has restricted everything to his personal life and none of his Bollywood paraphernalia around besides paparazzi. Coming from that, the actors in the film, Bamman Hirani, Sayaji Shinde as cameos, decent, they do a good job for that. Jim Sarf as the only negative character in the film is menacing and he leaves that impact in your head. Anushka Sharma is the most useless character in the film, which is normally not the case with Hirani, but here she's shown like a world famous biographer. So she should be aware that every celebrity you're gonna write about has pros and cons, has gonna have issues for and against. But at the drop of a hat, for every anti-Sanju story article for that matter, she is willing to drop everything. So I found that character, which is a fictionalized one as it is, a little off. Dia Mirza assaulted as Manyata. It purposely kept his family out of it, so there are no sisters, there is no Kumar Gaurav, and there are no Brat Pack, which were once upon a time famous, of Sunil Shetty, Salman Khan, Ajay Devgan around. But the one person who they focus completely on is, as a friend, is Kamli. That's Vicky Kaushal. Does Vicky Kaushal do a good job? No. He does an outstanding job. He nails his Gujarati mannerisms. So when you see him in Raman Raghav 2.0 as the junkie cop, and now you see him as Kamlesh Kapasi, you feel that you don't realize that it's the same actor, but you, that is two genuine brilliance of Hirani and Vicky Kaushal. He steals the movie from everyone else, just like Paresh Rawal does as Sunil Dutt. There were talks of Akshay Khanna trying to play the role and other people playing the role, vying for the role, but I think Hirani does a fantastic job by giving it to Paresh Rawal. The nuances which he captures, the way he has handled the scenes, brilliant. Ranbir Kapoor, everybody has been talking about it, but I'll put it this way, it was expected from him, and I'm so happy that he's done Sanju, because an actor of his caliber should be doing more of this and less of Bombay Velvets and Besharups. So yes, like the movie has a dialogue, Sanjay Dutt is back, I guess
Ranbir Kapoor is back, Baba. Actor bole to.
For Ranbir, this movie will go out as a lifeline for him. Paresh Rawal, fantastic. Vicky Kaushal owns the movie. Rajkumar Hirani will live. Now, I guess, is the only director to have 1,000 crores to his name. Justifiably so, once again. And Sanju has been immortalized.
Baba bole to.
Thank you. Does it have the wide factor? Definitely. A rating of 4.5 on 5.